G'day there, mates. My name is Mr. Magilla-cutti, and welcome back once again to my channel. Today, we'll be continuing the story of Dark Chronicle. Now, once again, we were just going to Mount Gondor again. Nothing really much happened there, except we only got one win of Speeder. I tried to do some of that on my offscreen time. I only did a couple of floors, but didn't really win that one. Though on the first floor, I did get the medal for clearing it without healing, so there is that. Anyway, enough of my rambling, let's just get into it, shall we? Okay, so let's go on door and go. Okay, defeating monsters using only a rod pod. I really need to start backtracking to get all the medals and all that. But with the time trial medals, basically to clear the floor in a certain amount of time, I want to at least get the, I can't remember the name of it, but there's a special pair of legs you can get this ride pod. Hold on. Here it is, the buggy. It basically goes at high speed, so combined that with the Nova Cannon we got from the Lunatic Laboratories, I think we'll be able to do some major damage to the enemies. Alright, so this is going to be Steve Slow alone. And yeah, Griffin is just flying around here. So if you're gonna win now, it's pretty much part of the control speed with the spell base. Look at the scrap metal. I'm just gonna have to remember to repair the
Wait till they get a load of this!
Repair the handball.
Your
rights. I probably should not afford that short block for Steve here. Let's go with the weapon.
Wait till they get a load of this!
Sorry, I should have switched to a different weapon.
You're kidding!
No, we're not kidding, Steve. Ooh. Flippin' elephant who had one had too much to eat and two had a nose job to shrink his trunk.
I'm a goner!
You're not a goner yet. This is definitely giving me a lot of those steering points.
You're kidding!
Especially towards the final four that we need. Okay, Max, have this last, please. Better drink the antidote drink just in case, because it does look like he is still losing health, even when he's not actually the one doing the fighting. Now, look at that antidote.
I'm a goner!
You doesn't watch me in that seat, though. But yeah, a couple of times when I try to do some off-screen stuff, I will start at the floor with just basically every single enemy just facing me.
I'm a like, goner!
Well, not every single enemy, about four or five of them just standing right in front of me. I tried to switch to Steve, but he got taken down instantly, sadly.
You're all beat up! Hurry up and get fixed!
Okay, there's our exit.
You're all beat up! Hurry up and get fixed!
Too late for that, but
I'm a goner!
And it's pretty nice, Steve. We'll tell you once we get out of here.
I'm a goner!
That's all of them. I don't think we got it all done within the time limit. Oh, we did it! No, we won't go there yet. Why did it say Monica? Nah. Alright, looks like this one will be a bit easier.
I'm a goner!
Be quiet. Get your head in the sand. Yeah, my best advice for doing the shortest time to take out all the enemies is to be using speed. And the propeller leg seemed to be a good idea. A better idea would be the buggy legs, because you just pretty much take off on. Okay, so I'm gonna just go for the center. So we got the big steam fountain here, but that's okay, because I think we can just get over it. Now, I don't want to hit the top of the roof there, so let's go medium. Ooh. Could have went a bit higher, but I'm fine with that. Choice, tough choice. Ooh, that was too much. Okay, I think I could just hit it straight into the hole. Yes, I can. Just don't mess up. Don't want to hit the wall, so let's go max power. Forces we need to clear, because I know we didn't clear quite a lot of them, but... You know, let's head back to Palm Brink and see if we actually done enough. I didn't know you can actually turn the voice off here. We'll turn it off for now. Alright, I'm going to quickly head back to Palm Bridge to see whether or not we can recruit the girls having some problems because of the anomaly hole, so I'll be back shortly. Okay, so apparently we still need to fix a couple more speeder holes. So I wish it actually told me how many more we need to do. Anyway, back to Mount Gondor. Depending on how well we do on the next floor here, I might actually do another one. Alright, so defeat all monsters with Max's right-hand weapon. Referring to the ranch. But I just sometimes need to double check myself. And keep getting at this point. Slappy definitely a good shot, but... Yeah, I think this was the weapon I needed all that... Yeah, a ton of wind crystals. Yeah, think it said I need 108. Okay, so the sapphire for 15. It's always good to double check. So I need at least about, I'm doing my math right, but something like that. At least 36 wind crystals. Be focusing on other women, but again, I like to get the metal so I can get out of the way first before, so I don't have to come back and do them later, because you know I will have to do them, especially with a floor that I have to take up all the enemies, including the bigger ones, with weapons I didn't have powered up yet. I mentioned doing speed runs with a steed there. I may just think about doing them on my off time, but we will see. Because I'm pretty sure you lot want to see me race and scream at my speeder all the time. I've got online, the best fish will definitely require lures. I don't believe I can actually take down the big trees now. Hello again.
Which shall it be?
Yellow.
Very good.
Ooh.
Here you are.
Nice. Okay, let's see which one of you is a myth. I can actually get up from rocks. Gonna continue to break them. And some rye pot fuel. That is definitely good. That's right. It's actually funny enough that I hardly spend that much money on buying rice for that. Most of the time it's just coming from inside the dungeon. Gotta remember to block those bites of theirs. Talk about hot chili powder and pepper heads and all that, but I still think people, a lot of people are crazy, especially pepper heads, will want to eat and stuff so spicy. And I believe the people, I'm not even going to use the word here, but I refer to them as suckers for punishment, because I know there are people out there who actually eat spicy food as part of a challenge. And I especially do it on my own YouTube channel. I thought that flip. Alright, one YouTuber watched Double Smash. He actually did this one challenge where he had a... I don't remember the name of the group, but they actually posted him something for a spicy challenge. And... like, he would do it, he would take. He took it and all that. And at first it didn't even faze him. I'm not sure if he was faking him or not, but as he took a lot more of the stuff, oh my god. He was in so much pain. And there were any viewers who, when he was doing his live, on the live stream, these viewers were actually saying more, a teaspoon more, a tablespoon more. Oh my god. It was, like, people actually offered him up $100. $100 for these challenges. It's like, guys, he's suffering enough already. See what you mean? And now this is a... I didn't watch the live stream live myself, but I'm just gonna believe some people like to see out of Japan. So then again, I suppose, as long as they're not the ones getting hurt, they don't give a damn.
Takes care of you guys.
But it just blows my mind that there still can be people out there who can be so sadistic seeing people suffer. Like, I know it's all fun and games, but I get, as the saying goes, it's all fun and games until someone gets hurt. And a dollar there was really, really hurting. I mean, thank god he had like a very tall milk drink for him, because I know for a fact that milk actually does help with the coping with like spicy food. But still, I just gotta say this. All you pepperheads out there, you guys are flippin' crazy. Alright, let's go for some more heads over here. I think that's too much. Oh no. Eh, that wasn't too bad. So we'll go a bit further, so about here. Ooh, that's good. Alright, so it's still blue, so... Where is it? Oh, it's only on side. Oh boy. We just needed to hit it once to turn red. Okay. Okay, we're good. One more hit. Better at this. Ooh, an amethyst. How many portions that was now? Death trap. And the feed using own arms? Yeah, we won't be doing that. Resident in a house of train. Resident in a house of arm. And operations room is full. Okay, so we've got a lot of this being done up now. Still, I mean, I know I can make the stone houses, but I think you can make other houses here too. First we'll see how far we get first before we actually do that. And also with that being said, I think I'll just do one resident at a time, like one objective at a time before I start moving on. And for example, I might start with just restoring the second floor first, and then I'll move on to the third floor and go down the list here. Let's see if we can do some stuff with Monica's ring here. Yeah. Oh yeah, also... I don't know why I did that. I did change the element on Monica's arm being too high. That magic attack that I see. Trying to hit him with the sword. I need to get back into the habit of saving my game before going back to the dungeon, because you never know what happens. Arts material, always nice to have. Holy Lord Almighty. Yeah. my problem. I get so tunnel vision with everything. I just go with one attack at a time, turn into a one trick pony. Don't come over here, fish. So if I could just level it up one more time, I should be able to use the power crystals here. I think I might have a level up power here. Wait, hold on, one sec. So you're going to only get 2 points off the crystals. But it does save me. What was that? I don't know what I'm talking about. Okay, moving on with... need to repair it. Okay, so we need to defeat a star tortoise and a rolling rock. So, the build something with a star armlet. I can get the attack, no problem. Flame definitely needs to go up a lot. Chill, not so much. And what's damage? Hold on. Let's see. One more smash. So I definitely need to get that up quite a fair bit. And S was the scales, I believe. I need to go up a fair bit as well.
Thank you.
think I'm going to have to start working on max stuff now. Especially the Starbreaker, yep. Thank you very much. I'm a bit too crazy, man. Oops, crazy. Again, I get so much tunnel vision, I don't even notice the weapon's durability. It's crap. Now, I know I have problems with the guard on Dark Cloud, but I know that's why I never use it too much. But on the other hand, the guard here is a lot more better, but it's good that they have some enemies that have guard breaks. That is, guard breakers. Because otherwise, the guard properties would just be overpowered. Definitely gonna be needed as for the cafeteria. The life of that. Listen, I ain't mimics here. That's a bit of a good sign. The power for well, one. But one's better than none. That's down there. Thief. Looks like this will help a couple enemies down. So it looks like there might be a mimic or two. Steve, this one's all yours, buddy. So there's no... I said I think there is. Let's have a quick look. Okay, so yes, there actually is. Okay, so desperation on the mountain. That'll be it for today's episode. Next episode will be the doing more of the mountain. But we'll see how things go for now. I know it's not that, it was that exciting, and I thought I was doing so well on speeder today, but I guess that last round, not so much. This is so bloody easy, but yet I undershot it. Really had a minigame. But anyway, that's going to do it for me. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys did enjoy this video, please remember that like button. Also, if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button to show support. I very much appreciate that. Okay. Now with that being said and done, I'm gonna end. I'll see if I can do Final Fantasy 7 or 9, but that's a big thing. So thank you all again, and I hope you all have a wonderful day. Take care yourselves. Enjoy safely out there, people. Bye-bye, take care, and have a good time.